Hello there guys and welcome back to the channel. So today's video is inspired by this tweet when I got tagged in by Rollo Tomasi. Basically he says if you're using Suicide Masteries and Gladiator Hulk on Degeneration Starburst type path, Galk regenerates from initial bleed, which I found quite noteworthy and I definitely wanted to point out and also check it out by myself. So he also has his footage attached there. I'm sure if you wish you can find it on Twitter. You have his username visible in the screenshot. Meanwhile we're gonna head in variant 2 where we have a Starburst lane and we're gonna showcase that ability of Gladiator Hulk and obviously a couple other small tidbits of information about Gladiator Hulk. So we are running Hela, which helps us go smashing much more often, not that it's particularly needed, but it's still fun. So the first fight is just like a warm-up. There is no active Starburst, therefore we're taking no kind of like extra damage, no face me active, but it is variant 2, and it also serves a purpose in this case to lower our health pool by enough to see some sort of noticeable difference in the next fight. So this fight's almost over. Obviously variant 2 plus Gladiator Hulk go extremely well together, therefore it wasn't the longest fight either, and yeah, we are pretty much ready to move on to the Starburst lane, and then we're gonna check out a few cool things about the Gladiator Hulk. And now we can see that the first fight is going to be Iceman, and it's actually kind of like a perfect showcase of another ability. Basically, when Face Me is active, any and all damage gets regenerated by X amount of percentage by Galk. And that also means that includes the Frostbite. So Gladiator Hulk here is an excellent kind of like showcase how we can see that the Frostbite is active, even though it's dealing quite a large amount of damage. All in all, Gladiator Hulk is still netting positive because, yeah, Face Me affects not only the passive damage itself that you're receiving, but while Face Me is active, you get to regenerate any and all damage you are sustaining, including physical hits to your face. Therefore, Gladiator Hulk is extremely user-friendly whenever Face Me is active and you are actually kind of like getting off scot-free when you're making mistakes. I'm going to showcase that again in the next fight against Corvus, because this Iceman fight's pretty much over, but we can see that there definitely was not a huge kind of like drop in our health pool, even though that cold snap should have gotten us down by a fair bit. And yeah, so now we're going to be moving on to Corvus. In this fight, I'm going to get hit a couple times as well, but initially I'm just going to let that Face Me heal, plus the bleed from suicides heal me up. As you can see, we started at 77%, we're going to 79%. So basically, for as long as the bleed is active, thanks to willpower and thanks to Face Me abilities, we are actually netting quite a bit of heal, and that is extremely efficient. And I'm sure there are quite few of you who already knew that, and that is precisely the reason you love Gladiator Hulk. However, perhaps if you were unaware of these kind of interactions, they might make you rethink your opinion. And as we can see, even though we kind of like ate a full combo in the face from Corvus, we are still at 72% health, pretty much unaffected by that Starburst at large. And we can also absorb the recoil damage to a large degree. And all in all, it is extremely kind of like easy time managing Suicide Masteries with Gladiator Hulk with added benefit of healing. So even though typically Gladiator Hulk is not particularly suicide friendly champion, whenever you go into these Starburst lanes so on and so forth, it is actually helping him quite a bit, because obviously he's not the strongest damage dealing champion, and now he can hit much better than he does otherwise. And additionally, you are effectively gaining quite a bit of health, so we are currently still healing up. I believe we started at like 70% health or close to that, and currently we are at 76% of the health towards the end of the fight, 77. It's pretty much perfect for us, so we finished on 77% health, and yeah, even though Starburst is active, we finished with a net positive of health. And there's going to be one more fight, I believe this is the last fight, where we're going to go from 77% to 80% something. Even though we have the Starburst, we have some chip damage, it is a fairly kind of like cool little interaction and the fact that Suicide Master is actually help him out quite a bit damage wise plus let him heal, I think it's quite cool and definitely noteworthy. But either way, that will be pretty much it for today's video. I have said what I wanted to say, and yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you find it useful or interesting, definitely hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, hit all the buttons, and stay notified for any and all upcoming videos that will be coming to the channel shortly. So definitely stay tuned. Some good stuff is coming. See you guys.